Alright, what is up, guys? Welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. Now, here's the biggest thing. I sent out that tweet that I was talking about in episode 1, and no reply. Now, I did tag both Michael and Jeremy in it, like I said in the description for that video. And yeah, like I said, no reply. Now, I did also look at both their feeds just to see if anybody had actually sent them anything and they had retweeted it. And Jeremy had one from Wednesday, 2 days prior, that pretty much said that he's been getting a lot of pictures. Now, what I had done was I had actually tweeted a picture of my character and said, you know, Michael, Jeremy, you guys said no one would. Well, I am. And then I also put a link to the video. So, yeah. I have absolutely no idea even if they saw it, let alone skimmed over it just because of the picture. So, I'm thinking maybe I shouldn't have added the picture. But anyways, so here's the big thing, though. Even though I didn't get that, when I checked it, I want to say it was last night. Well, for me, it's Saturday night right now. So when I checked it last night, I think it was at 5 views. So I don't know if it's gotten any more or not since then. And yes, if EA is watching, I am making sure to keep them unmonetized until I can fill out the proper paperwork to get them fully monetized. So, there's that. Anyways. Whew. Okay. So, at the same time, I also, was watching a few videos on things that you can do in the game, and I could not figure out what the melee button was the entire first two videos. So I came over here just now, well, before the video started too, and found out the Y button is melee. So if I can get back into combat, I will show you guys a little trick I picked up. Okay. Okay. Alright, so what do I gotta do? Okay, there's stairs there, but I gotta go up there. Okay.
This is Nexus Control to Hyperion.
Yep, out of sight.
How the hell should I know?
Excellent. Let's go over the document.
Okay.
If you want to keep it, do it.
Yep, Addison.
Alright, what happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec. Not how he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
Ooh. This one's a tough one. I mean, I've been truthful the whole time, so why not?
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 40 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Okay. Oh, this is good. Okay.
There's also this strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Okay. So I'll post.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
Wow. Okay. Director position.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away. And here we are, idling.
Sorry, I'm in a little bit of a sneezing fit. Give me one second. Alright. Sorry about that. You didn't hear that because I edited it out, but still, I mean, seriously, it's... I hate my nose sometimes. Anyways, continue.
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends, or...?
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much like a colonial director without colonies.
Huh. That is pretty true. So, last one then.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder. Not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
That is true. But still, I mean... You would think they would have an actual plan for the hostiles. Like... Okay, these guys aren't treating us very well. I mean, you know, we're here to pretty much take over the planet, you know, colonize and try and make peace, but at the same time, you know, kill anything that gets in the way. The only problem, you would think anything that just sees you as a threat, no matter what you're planning, no matter what you try to say, no matter what kind of peace talks you try to deal, anything that sees you as a threat, you've got to have a plan against that type of hostility. It's weird to not have one. All right.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
Hmm. Tan, Kesh, and Kandros. Huh. Who's you?
Hello, console. You and I are going to be very good friends. We'll get you all fixed up and ready to go in no time.
Okay. Alright. So there's someone over there, someone over there, and someone through those doors. I think I'm gonna go over here. And jump. Nope. No jump. Oh. Okay. So then let's go up here. Here we go. Conjurus. Okay. Mariette?
This is wrong. Just wrong.
Okay.
It's not right. It's not fair.
What's wrong?
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
Okay, what was the crime?
What exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Okay. Yeah. Huh. First side quest. Why not?
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
All right. And the cat's up here. I knew you couldn't resist getting on that tray table. Okay. Sorry, dealing with the cat. Lieutenant, based on reports, status report 16C, seems we're no closer to gaining a foothold in any sector. Without a decent recon and greater intel on this enemy, I'm starting to think our efforts are futile. Risks involved and continued loss of resources and lives make it hard to justify. Morale this low, we need to scale down expectations again. Kandris. Alright. That would be this guy.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Arc.
What's the word on the Turian Arc?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Alright. Let's first find out about your role.
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those cat found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Huh. So he basically had the exact same thing that we had. Okay, so what about coming to Andromeda?
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know? Then my sister became a sculptor and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that I stayed in service. But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
Hmm. I hope he becomes a playable character. Or not, you know, a playable character, but a willing participant in the carnage that is about to follow in the next rest of the game. Turian Welfare, how about that?
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
That is true. What about the uses?
It's rough out there. I might need backup if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
All right. Okay, and the Ket.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
All right. And that's it.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
All right. Now, what's this guy doing over here? Hi. Why were you crouched down like it's a military drill? Huh. Oh, strike team missions.
This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization to participate.
Speak to Kandros. Wait. What was that? Journal. Getting to know the Nexus. Okay. Oh. Nexus. Yep. And then priority ops. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna hold off on that one. Hey, there's you. And you. Hi, guys.
Pathfinder, no time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is it. Let's call it strained.
I can believe it. Nexus is running on empty.
Not just that. A lot of the exiles were security. Everyone was trained and armed for Frontier. We know Ket are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
Yeah.
They were frustrated. If they just wanted to kill, they could have fought to the last here.
Apparently we're the big hope for everyone. Not the Hyperion showing. Just us. I'm with you. It's just a lot.
We'll get it back.
As long as the Nexus is here, as long as we're here, we have a job to do.
Double down crisis mode. I can do that. We can do that. Ready and willing, Pathfinder.
Uh-huh. All right. Back on
too small for
track. You'd be surprised.
Oh. There's also Vervine in the seed bank.
Okay. So left or right, left or right, left or right, left or right, left. Let's go. Okay.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
You trust me now?
I thought I didn't measure up as Pathfinder.
Director Addison keeps her own counsel. I keep mine.
And when you disagree?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself.
Well, split difference.
The scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the golden worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Huh. Just point the way.
Just point me to my ship and I'll be out of here.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for EOS will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Sam Nude on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No. I'm fine.
Alright. Okay.
Ryder, you have my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
Any idea where they went?
Nothing certain, but tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Troubles.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Carson, is dead.
Whoa. All right, Carson's death.
How did Gian Carson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Carson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
Alright, what about the disaster, too?
Kandros mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen? Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
Okay, where are the Krogan then?
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
I already know where the dislike comes from. I mean, they are Solarians, right? I think I remember them being Solarians. Yeah. I'm just going to say Tan's people, just because I don't remember the exact name for them. If I am right, I am right. If I am wrong, I am wrong. But with Director Tan, his people don't like the Krogans because of the fact that in Mass Effect 2, I believe it was, revealed that they actually messed up something in the Krogan's DNA, which pretty much brought their breeding rates down. So, yeah. But their dislike is pretty much, it's pretty much the same as, I guess you would call it the exact same thing as a neo-Nazi against those of color or Jewish faith. Pretty much. So, let's actually see what his true answer is, or what they programmed his answer to be.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
That is true. I also do remember that from when it was brought up in Mass Effect 2. But still, I mean, the Krogans don't like them because of the fact of that being, you know, of them dropping their birth rates. So I think it's kind of double-edged right there. Because it's not just the fact that they're, you know, a warring people, that they're hired muscle, but also the fact that they don't like them. They don't like Tan's people because Tan's people did something horrible to them, and Tan's people don't like them because of the fact that they're, like I said, hired muscle. So, yeah, I mean, it's extremely much harder to explain than just what Tan just said, so.
What more can you tell me about the initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
All right.
What do you know about the early days of the initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Okay.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
Very true, but still.
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
Solarian, I thought so. Either way, the dislike for Krogan's already been answered, so other questions. Other questions. And Tan's role.
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here, or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
Okay.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles. Some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Really?
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Really now? Huh.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, Colonists being murdered on site can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
Forward stations. I know the term, but I've never actually heard the full definition, so...
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
Great. Just great. So yeah, forwarding station is pretty much the epicenter of everything, which includes... mining, obviously, amongst other things, and yeah, it's no, that's so not cool. Why do I get to test it out? Oh yeah, that's right, because all the other arcs are missing. Which, by the way,
any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
Eh?
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave, but before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
Well, that's a good thing, I guess. So, yeah.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm happy to help. You will find our futures depend on each other's success. Good luck.
Of course it does. Okay. Okay, one more to talk to.
Yeah. Looks fine so far.
Which is over here. Oh, container. Yay.
Yes, I know the Hyperion docking unannounced caused some switches to blow. That's fine. I don't care. We know the problem is more widespread than we thought. We're working to fix it. That's all.
Okay. There we go.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
Alright. Krogan whereabouts?
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the initiative.
That's what it is. That's why there's no Krogans.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
Okay, then yeah, why are you still here?
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Huh. All right. Nexus's problems.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, was killed.
Okay, I already know, but...
What happened to Gian Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders. Tan might know more.
Of course, and he told me, so I should have come here first. Seriously, more Nexus problems? Really?
I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
Okay. I'll make sure to get you some. So, the genophage. That's what it was. Here we go.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with a genophage.
Right. The genophage. A little gift to our people from the Salarians thousands of years ago. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
Yep.
No wonder your people have such a problem with Salarians.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Salarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Salarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about new beginnings. My people need that more than most.
I actually did not know that the Turians were involved. I thought it was just a Salarian Krogan thing. I must not have been paying attention when I was playing too.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show mutation against the virus. A natural defense. During the trip to get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. It's still early, but I think we made a dent. Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we had. Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
That is true. Okay, what about your job?
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place. I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible. Considering.
Okay, so that's that.
Nothing more for now.
Good luck out there.
All right.
My crew is working.
So
on.
Now.
We've moved the op center to the.
Okay, so before we get there to better beginning. Okay, back. Missing arcs. Okay. Here we go. Track that one. There we go. Okay. Okay. There's also a question mark around here somewhere. What is this? Oh, information wall. Okay. Oh.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arms got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
Why paranoid?
What is there to be paranoid about?
We've had 3 malfunctions in the past week.
That's not good. Sorry. Understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Did you report it?
Did you talk to security about this?
How can I? For all I know, someone in security is the one doing this. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait. That's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny.
Of course.
Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Of course.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni-tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Okay. That works. Okay. So.
Find out why. Be careful.
Okay. So let's talk to this guy.
Help you?
Pathfinder Ryder, here to see Nilkin Rensis.
Ah, our murderer. Wife's here all the time. Guess she told you her sob story. Nilkin, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanted to chat with you.
The Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
Your wife's all broken up over this. She says you didn't do it, and that she loves you.
She's a wonderful person. At this point, it's too late. They found me guilty.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend, he refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
Well, of course, arguments happen.
Last I checked, getting into a spat wasn't against the law.
There's more. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and I guess I panicked and fired. Witness saw the chief's chest explode.
Sounds like an accident.
That's what I told them, but I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
Don't throw in the towel yet. I'll review the evidence. Maybe I can find something that'll help.
That would be great. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Of course. Of course there's still hope, dude. Can't give up over an accident.
That's the console for our strike teams.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex, combat experts who've signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
You're trusting them to me?
I'll deploy your people carefully, Kandros.
Appreciate that, Ryder. But trust me, Apex can handle themselves. Authorization complete. Good luck out there.
Okay, now the real reason I'm here.
No news on the Turian Ark yet. Or is this militia business?
Murder case.
I spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
Is that a reach?
Doesn't seem right to put all that on him.
Of course it isn't, but that's the perception. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
And you assume he's lying.
What's a lie to a murderer? Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you cue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
I may find something against that. Sorry, pal.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
All right. Now where? Oh, I hear them. Okay.
The Nexus versus Colonist Nilkin, Evidence 7A.
Hiram! Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back.
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to...
No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power from the Hyperion. That didn't sound right. Repair requests are currently on hold until power coupling is complete.
Alright, moving on. Docking clamps. Fully active
and engaged. Cassidy Shaw? I'm Ryder. I'm looking into the Nilkin murder case.
Oh man, I thought that was over with. Have you heard the audio recording of their fight?
Yes.
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the Chief. He looked right at Nilkin and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Did you see any Ket in the vicinity?
Nilkin said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
Did Nilkin seem remorseful?
I lost sight of Nilkin in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated. Could have been guilt. The reality of the act sinking in.
If they'd fought and Nilkin threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Friends fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part. The Chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer. In retrospect, it is ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
I appreciate the information.
Of course.
Very weird.
It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Tan wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
Well, that's bull. Tan, what are you hiding?
Something I can help you with?
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to Eos and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
The more certain we can be, the better.
Very
all
true.
Right, but let's keep it quiet. I don't want people thinking we're reopening the case. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it.
Of course.
We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene. Good luck.
Thank you.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course.
Okay. Wait. Nope, nothing. Okay.
Please be advised that Hyperion docking procedures are now complete.
Alright. So now that's done. Station sabotage. Okay. Oh, right back over here. Okay.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel.
Tram technicians, please report to the Hyperion.
Is up here.
Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
Okay. Alright. Which means... go scan this one over here. Oh. Explosion site. Doesn't seem to be anything else near it. And then this one over here.
Hyperion power draw is now at 100%.
Huh?
Scan and trace the wiring to locate the panel that the saboteur used.
Nope. Upstairs. Through here.
Tram technician.
Pathfinder, I received the data from Sam.
There we go.
It really is sabotage.
Any idea as to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion main deck.
On the Hyperion? Oh, no, 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 no. No, you are not doing anything to the Hyperion. Nope. You even dare try to do anything to the Hyperion, I will kick your ass. I hope I get a QTE so that way I can just stab the bitch. I mean, that would be so much simpler than anything else, really. Okay, now, where? Huh? That way, okay. There you are. Hi.
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here. I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing, and it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
Looks like someone is using both you and Raj to cover their tracks.
They need pretty high-level access for that. Still, it's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless.
No, it's
not. I wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams.
All right.
Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's...
Really? Figure someone's what? Oh, well, either way, it's just simply put, same exact thing. I'm gonna finish this one before I finish the episode, so. And who knows, I might actually do one for Friday. I mean, there's no blanket coverage, so. You know what? Yeah, I'm just gonna do it for Friday. Why not? Wait. The heck? Am I going back? Oh. I've got to go to operations, not to habitat. I don't like that. I really don't like that. Multiple points to where to go? Yeah, I don't like it. But hey, this is the episode of Sidequest, so why not? Let's get lost along the way, shall we? Okay. Let's go. Go, go, go. And there we are.
Tempest crew should report to the docking area.
Security footage. Oh, whoa. Okay. Jarntan, okay. From Tirin. Trail's cold. Found what looks like abandoned camps of Piper system. Okay. Good. One objective sending a small discrete reconnaissance team. Found out which Sloan and the X-Men might have gone. Not who I thought she was. It won't be a problem. Kelly Corbanus may have started it, but Sloan made her allegiance is clear. And she held you in high regard, hoping to be your partial. Need my people focused on defending the station, not taking inventory. And the militia oversight, Sergeant Nels, to look at it. said, my understanding, XOs were more Calyxus people than Sloan's. Isn't he the one who started the mutiny? There was a mutiny aboard the Nexus during your absence. It's escalated quickly, blah, blah, blah. Huh. Okay. Nexus instability detected, timestamp scrambled, playback corrupted.
This file is useless. Let's check another.
Okay. Huh. Same thing.
And another scrambled file.
Coincidence seems unlikely.
Let's check another.
Maybe they slipped. Failsafe, system restored, administrator override required.
This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Uh-huh. Somebody working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled, but if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
But yeah, it's only giving me two targets. Huh. Okay.
Negative match.
Uh-huh. Okay. Oh.
Negative match.
Okay, so pretty much I would have to go through every human until I get the right one. That's pretty much it, right? Hey, Cora. Habitation. This time we're actually going to habitation. Of course, in the next episode, we'll finish it off. Whew, this is getting good, but these side quests are a little bit longer than, you know, something that would be relative to it. And plus, at the same time, I'm only 94 XP till from leveling up. Really? Wow. That's actually pretty decent. So, either way, I wonder what that AVP is. What I have to do to get AVP. Anyways, so Friday, instead of doing two videos of Resident Evil 7, I'll do another episode of Mass Effect Andromeda. Because A, I want to finish the side quest real quick before I do anything else. And B, well, before I do that, I gotta go blow my nose from all that sneezing earlier. Oy. Anyways, so let's just put it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 times I've had to edit this audio. 15 times. Yeah, I write down the time code so that way I can go back and edit that little chunk. Anyways, so yeah. So I will be back in just a few moments. You guys will see it on Friday. But this game is amazingly splendiferously amazing awesome, and I need an energy drink because it's 10:40 right now, Saturday evening, 2 days prior to this being uploaded. And not only am I going to be doing another video on Mass Effect Andromeda, but I've also got to get another video for Watch Dogs 2 and another video for Final Fantasy 15 before I go to bed, at the very least. It's crazy. Anyways, so that's it from me. Thank you guys for watching. And of course, as always, happy hunting.